What are you worried about? You are worried about your rizq, sustenance. You don't come to the salah because you are working. You don't come to the jum'ah because you want to earn $20 or $50 more. You don't come to the jama'ah because you are worried about your rizq. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, your provision and your rizq is in the sky. And swear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the Lord of the sky and the earth, it is right as you are giving spilling of your tongue. Can I take your tongue to talk my words? No. Can you take my tongue to talk your words? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tied us up this one. This is the tongue that I have given you to talk. And your rizq is same like the tongue that I have given you. Allah will give it to you. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us in the hadith, Inna nafsan lan tamuta hatta tastawfi rizqaha wa ajalaha. No one will die until he take all what is belong of his provision. So why we are worried? Why we are worried about this dunya? Knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decided for us the rizq 50,000 years before he created heaven and earth. Brothers, if we have yaqeen with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us in a hadith al-Qudsi an Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, this is narrated in al-Bukhari, hadith al-Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أنا عند ظن عبدي بي وأنا معه إذا ذكرني. I am as my servant think of me. If we have yaqeen with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we'll become like Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. You know who is Abdul Rahman ibn Auf? One of the greatest Muslim ever. One of the best men ever walk earth. When he leave Mecca, his mother told him, Ya Abdul Rahman, you are one of the richest people. If you become Muslim and you follow Muhammad to Medina, I will give you nothing. He said, Mom, I don't need anything. I have Allah. And he traveled to Medina. When he arrived Medina, he had 4 dirham. How much 4 dirham? $4. That's what he got. His brother, the Ansari, told him, Abdul Rahman, I am a rich man. I'll give you one of my shops. Take it. I'll give you one of my wives. You select which one. I'll make divorce and you marry her. Abdul Rahman tell him, Dullani ala suq. Show me where is the market. The man laughed. He tell him, show you to the market. You know this share market, the Jews are controlling the Medina market. Millions and millions of dollars is being exchanged. What you can do with this market? He tell him, I have yaqeen with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With the dua of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I swear by Allah, if I take any stone, I would find money under it. That's how much I have yaqeen with Allah. Do we have yaqeen with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If we don't have yaqeen and our iman is little, then we only blame ourselves if we're running after this dunya. But if we have yaqeen with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one can sleep, can go and die before he gets his rizq. I will teach you something that is asbab rizq. 7 asbab, subhanallah. There are so much reasons, but I will mention each one of them and I will tell you a little story about this sabab. What are the asbab, the reasons of rizq, the abundance of rizq, feeling too much you have abundance of wealth? Jazakallah khair. This istighfar is number 4. I want number 1. Al-Iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
ولو أن أهل القرى آمنوا واتقوا لفتحنا عليهم بركات من السماء والأرض.
If the people of the towns, they believe and they fear Allah, we shall open for them abundance from sky and from earth.
ولكن كذبوا, but they deny.
A little girl for one of the mashayikh, one of our big mashayikh, Sheikh Hatim al-Asam, one of the knowledgeable people. He have 9 daughters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you all beautiful daughters. That will be a reason for you to go to Jannah. Say Ameen. He have 9 daughters. And this man, he like to go to Hajj and like to go to knowledge. And he is knowledgeable person. One day he talked to his wife, I am traveling for knowledge. I will do my Umrah and I will traveling for knowledge. His wife and daughters told him, Father, if you travel, who will provide us food? You know, that time there is no fridge, nothing. There is one girl for him, 10 years old. She said, Father, you go. If you go, the one who is Ar-Razzaq is here. Don't worry. So she encouraged him and he left. In the night, next day, no food. Everybody come to this girl. Tell her, hey, why you talk to our father to travel? Look, now we don't have food. The girl, she went inside and she made dua. And the door knock. Someone is knocking the door. Who is that? It is the prince Abu Ja'far al-Mansur. That time, he is a prince of the army. And their house is scattered outside. Excuse me, sir, what would you like? He said, me and my, you know, cavalry, few hundred men of the army, we need water. They tell him, wallahi, we don't have anything except water. They gave him water. Then he said, whose house is this? They tell him, this is the house of Hatim al-Asam. Allah, Hatim al-Asam, our knowledgeable sheikh. Where is he? He traveled outside for knowledge and for Umrah. Abu Ja'far al-Mansur, with the money that he have on his horse, he took a big bundle of gold. He threw it in their door. He said, any one of you soldiers love me, do like me. So all the soldiers, they throw their gold and silver. The house become very rich. The wife and the daughters become very happy. But that girl, 10 years old, she cry. They tell her, why you cry? We become the richest house in town. She tell them, I am not crying because we have money. I'm crying because if a man who is created by Allah decided to make you rich, look how much money he can give you. What about if the Razzaq himself want to make you rich? Nothing can stop you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give rizq to anyone abundance without calculation. But do we have the iman? Do we have the yaqeen? Do we have what is truly that Allah is al-Razzaq? If we know that Allah is al-Razzaq, then we would know that our life and rizq is in Allah's hand.